bit closer.
There you go. Now we're doing it. Okay, so she's amazing, and I think she's such a great inspiration to anyone because she's so happy, she's so kind, she's extremely thoughtful, and she's just a pleasure to be like, if I am to have a best friend, I'd love for her like to be Nina. She's just the coolest girl. Like, you want to have friends that are like fun and loving and caring. She's like one of those girls. And I love her. And you love her. And the boys are very cute.
So who's your favorite boy?
David.
Okay.
Oh,
David.
Okay.
Come down.
Do you guys want to come down? Yeah, it just feels really weird.
Come on, make it personal.
Let's make it personal.
You can actually say you've had almost one.
Otherwise, it like makes me feel weird. I feel like I'm on stage. And I'm not really a stage actor.
You kind of tried to extend, but you
can't.
I know. I feel like I'm like, you know, about to like make like mathematical equations over here. I'm getting like sweaty over here. I'm, you know. So it's nice that it's like this. But yeah, you guys are all Vampire Diary fans. So, I'll tell you just a little bit about Vampire Diaries. We shoot at nighttime, most of the time, so a lot of scenes at nighttime. So the schedule is very different because you sleep during the day and then you work during the night and then the weekend comes in and you want to hang out and enjoy your time. So it's actually quite heavy schedules and, you know, we got very tired. We work with a lot of blood. I didn't realize that blood actually has different tastes. Now they offer you blood in cherry, I believe also strawberry, and some other flavors. So they'll come in to you and say, okay, so we're doing some blood. What type of, like, what kind of blood do you want?
What
flavor would you like? And you're like, today I feel like cherry. But it's all from syrup, made from syrup. And then, so that's kind of like main two things. It's a lot of blood and a lot of night work. But we also shot in Atlanta, and that was such a wonderful experience. It was a new place. I ended up going only for one episode, and of course they didn't reveal that who I am to anybody. Like, I didn't know. I just knew this is my character, and she shows up in this town, and then she, you know, all hell breaks in. So when I went there, I thought I was going just for 8 days, and then next thing you know, I'm there for 8 months, and we're shooting 12-13 episodes. And an interesting thing about TV show, we were talking about it yesterday, like when you do a movie, you go from, you know, beginning, middle, and the end. You know where you start with your character, you know all the relationship to other characters, and you kind of, you know, work your way all the way to the end of the script. With a TV show, you don't know. I didn't know for the longest time our relationship with Nina, our characters. I didn't know that. So with time, we were trying to ask all this question, well, what about this, what about that? And the writer's like, just make your own choices of the character, and then we will reveal what's happening. So it's very interesting because you, when you shoot, you don't really, you can't really develop, you don't know, your character's not developed, so you kind of have to bring your own story to it. And like, I had to create my own parents, or if I didn't have parents, or I had to create like where I was from and how did I get here to this little town. And it was a very interesting process. So it's a bit of a I guess more of a challenge to shoot TV shows than a movie. I cried too, as you saw. And speaking about crying, I'll get to that. But as you saw, like, I cried too, and I've never died before. So I was like, you know, my whole thing was like, well, how do I die? And so I started looking at, like, you know, different movies and how people die. And there's a lot of different deaths. You know, some people, like, die slowly. Some people, you know, try to die dramatically. So I was like, how would I die? But long story short, that was like a fun part of it. You know, because it was the last episode, we had to say not only in that scene, but like I had to leave literally the next morning. So for us, it was a very sad moment, but it was beautiful because we all came together and we all had to cry in the scene. So we all kind of cried for each other in the scene and outside of the scene, saying goodbye. But that would be probably one of my, you know, they all were great, but because it was such an impact, and then we couldn't stop crying because we were like, leaving all the way to you again. You know, that kind of thing. Because you get used to everybody, it becomes your family, you spend so much time together.
Well, unfortunately, because we have a gent who's on a wheelchair at the very top,
okay.
We need to have microphones so
they can... Hi! Hey! Hi! How are you? Good to see you again. We were just talking about... what were we talking about? Oh, my favorite scene of Vampire Diaries. You haven't seen it, so I'm not going to say it right now. Thank God you didn't hear it, because he hasn't seen it yet. He's about to see it. So, oh, next subject. Okay, so, oh hey!
I have to go.
Hi!
I just wanted to see you before.
Good to see you. Thank you so much for seeing, even just for a little bit.
Thank you. Bye.
Bye.
Okay, so another thing about Vampire Diaries is that, a fun fact. I'll just do fun facts, and then if you have questions, let me know. So another fun fact about Vampire Diaries, you know, for an actor, I haven't done prior to it a lot of like crying scenes. And you know, most of the time, a lot of actors will use fake tears, and they can look very real, by the way. In Vampire Diaries, they don't like using fake tears, so you have to cry. So when I came in, I was really nervous because, you know, it's a big show, and it's my first day. Well, speaking about my first day, I'll tell you what it is, but when I got to crying, so it's my first crying scene, I was like, oh, God, I gotta cry. So I'm trying to get myself into this crying mode. And I thank God I cried. Like it went, I connected to the character, I connected to the moment, and I felt it, and the tears came out, and I was like, oh, thank God. Had to. They go like, that was great. Now let's do it again. And I was like, oh. And then let's do it again. Let's move the camera to a different angle. Let's move it a little closer. Let's move it a little far away. So like 5 times into it, you're like, I have any more tears. I'm like, I don't know how I can do this. So it was very, I learned how to cry on the cue right then. And I realized that's not actually scary when you connect it to a character and you actually like feel what you say and you're true to it. So, but then they decided that, you know, now that you can cry on the cue, we're going to write crying on every single episode. That's great. So I was like, cries again. No. Yes. So that was interesting. But my first day was the most important day because your first day is the one that, you know, you kind of break the ice and, you know, you get to meet all the characters. And when I came in, I met Rebecca. Right? You remember the scene of my introduction? So I show up on set and this beautiful girl Rebecca comes out, this pale skin, blonde hair, and she goes, hi, so you and I, we're gonna be in bed together. And I said, yes. So here we are, the ice is broken. I had to kiss a girl for the first time. I'm sorry I had to tell you this. So that was an interesting thing because all of a sudden I come and I'm like, oh, I have to kiss a girl and I have to be in bed with another girl and a boy, like together. And that's my introduction. That's me saying, oh, hi, by the way, let's go. And let's just start doing it right now. And then the wardrobe department comes in and they go, okay, well, here's your wardrobe. And then there's like a tray, right? And then they give you your wardrobe. And your wardrobe is pretty much just a cover up, right? Because you have to be pretending you're in bed. I mean, you have your pajama bottoms and then you have. So, you know, my first wardrobe is nothing, really. So that kind of broke the ice, and after that we were all friends, and, you know, there was not much time to say, you know, hey, nice to meet you. It was kind of like, hey, we're now like this. So yeah, that was my first day at work. So that was a fun fact. And, you know, they were all so great, they're a great team, they're like a big, big family pretty much. You know, I came in, it was season 5, So they've been together for quite like, you know, a long time, and they've done their relationships, and, you know, they knew each other quite well. But they made me feel so comfortable that, you know, the first night they right away invited me out. They said, hey, so welcome. And then Julie Clack, who, you know, she invited us, and it was a big dinner. And then all of a sudden we all were hanging out after work. We were at work all the time. We were doing our job. And then in the evening time, and when the new cast kept coming in, they would be invited. And it was just really cool. And like, my birthday was in October, and, you know, I don't really like, we still working together, we got to know each other, but I didn't think they're gonna like throw a like a dinner party for me. And I was like, oh, this is so cool, like, I love this, this is great. So they were very nice, and it was a great experience. It was my first TV show, so I didn't really know how to work on TV. I knew movies, but not TV really. So it was a great learning experience, and I say, to me, it probably was like the best acting school ever. Because you're there and you have to do it, and it was fantastic. Questions? By the way, makeup, fun fact, my makeup on my death scene, wherever you see it, you didn't see it, I'm not gonna say anything, but makeup wise, it took a long time. It's about 2 hours to do that scene, because they have to put all that stuff and makeup and it and all the like little gashes or whatever they did on the arm and all the infection on the arm. It's taking a long time, but it's such a fascinating process. Like, I literally would sit there and watch our makeup artist putting it on and be like, oh my God, it does look scary. And then I remember I went with my makeup on my death scene right after we went to a bar, and I didn't really take it off. So, you know, some people had questions. Some people just looked at me funny. Yeah, any questions?
Any questions from up the top?
Any questions? Anything you want to know about filming?
Have you got any more upcoming projects?
I do have. I have a movie, well, I did a different TV show called Agent X. We only did one season, we didn't go anywhere further. But that one would be a fun to watch if, you know, I guess they have it on, I don't think they have it on Netflix, but Apple TV has it, and I'm sure if you Google online you can find it. But I played, it was a nice character, I did a lot of stunts, and she's funny, she's kind of crazy funny. I liked it, I enjoyed it. And then I have a movie coming out with Charlie Sheen and Whoopi Goldberg. It's drama, it's based on the true events of 9/11, and it's about 5 people being stuck in the elevator when the plane hits the buildings, and then trying to escape. And since then, they actually changed the safety of elevators in tall buildings, where now you can actually kind of open it and unlock it as an emergency lock, where before it was very far away and there's a whole complication with locking elevators. Or there's like an emergency thing where they can open it from outside, you don't have to climb out and open it. And then I have a TV show that I did for Netflix that should come out in November, I believe, I'm not really sure. That's a sci-fi, so if you guys are into sci-fi, that one you're gonna love. They've put a lot of money into it. It's a great cast, and visually it's amazing, because they've built like a building like this, and they've built the outside futuristic city inside the building with streets and bridges, and like, I mean, it's fascinating. So that could be a cool show too. And then, you know, now I'm back into searching for a new job, and I'm doing other things beside it, because every actor should have a business on the side.
You're still doing modeling on the side as well?
Not as much. You know, I'm over that age. And I don't eat carrots anymore. I do eat, no, I love doing modeling. Hang on, I'm having a super time over here. I love doing modeling. It's just I've outgrown it.
You like food?
I love food.
What's your favorite food?
As a matter of fact, you know, we have my favorite food here or like anywhere.
Anywhere.
Like, I honestly love I love a lot of food. So it's like, I have to define it, whether it's going to be like what I love in sushi or like what I love in burgers, or like, I mean, love Italian, love sushi, My favorite thing here is a shepherd pie. And I've learned they come in different shapes and forms here in England. They're not just a shepherd pie, they like have other stuff in it. Different meat, I guess, and there's a different name to it. Fish and chips here, awesome. I don't know where they're gonna take me for dinner tonight, but I'm excited. The menu is fantastic. But we have somebody here who keeps like literally like popping out from nowhere, right? He was popping out from nowhere. It was like my voice. And I was like, wait, did I hear him? And then he was standing behind me. But for a second, I was like, he isn't in my head. And he goes, are you eating again? No? Just snacking? Is that food? So, that was, yes, love eating. What else? Anything? Anything you want to know about me, about the show? Anything?
Did you carry on watching the show after it, after you, like, finished?
Did I watch my show? Yeah. Yes or no? It's really hard to watch yourself when it's done because it's just weird. I don't know how to explain it. Because also you're looking at yourself and it's like you're literally just looking at yourself. No, because you want to see the whole show, but you're like, wait, what did I do? Did I lie there? No, I didn't lie. I could have done this. No, maybe I could have done that. And then it like drives you completely insane. So no, I didn't watch it. But with the death scene, I gotta tell you, my mother watched it. And she called me the next morning and she was so angry. And I said, why are you yelling at me? And my mom never yells at me. And she was just like, ugh, irritated. And I said, mother, what's up? She goes, I didn't sleep all night. And I said, okay, why? I watched your death scene yesterday. And I said, uh-huh. She goes, and I cried all night until 6 o'clock in the morning. And I was like, well, that's good, right? So you believed it. She goes, yes, but oh, I didn't sleep all night. And I'm like, well, that's not my fault. So I guess that made, because my mom is probably one of my best friends, but she's also a great critique. And when my mom loves my work, that's when I know I nailed it. And then I'm meeting my mother, by the way, this trip. And my mom and I are going to go around Europe. And we're going to travel a little bit. So I'm very excited. She's never seen Europe. So it's going to be a fun trip with my mom. Yay. Fun fact. When you choose a character, a lot of times wardrobe department would work with you to build your character. And fun fact, I like these kind of bracelets with these kind of guys, right? So I like these guys. And when we kind of started reading about my character and we started talking to the wardrobe department, I said, she's kind of rock and roll. Like, she needs to be rock and roll. She needs to like kind of have my essence to her, because when it gets to her history of her family and like why she became the way she became, I couldn't relate to her because I didn't come from that background. So I had to read about abandoned children and like how that, you know, what they think and how that affects them, and to really understand her, right? But I had to also put a bit of me into her to make her believable. And I said, you know, it would be interesting because I like leather jackets. I love jeans. And I kind of love like this rock and roll jewelry. Can we use it? And I said, can we just use these like in every scene? Can it be like her thing? And she goes, yeah, let's do this. So it was really fun because when you watch it, you're like, it's kind of like me on a daily basis. I have jeans, I have leather jacket, and I still have the bracelets. And I still look like Nadia. I don't know what else you got. Anything else you want to know? Like,
what made you actually choose to have a role in Vampire Diaries?
What
made you choose to have a role in Vampire Diaries?
Sorry, what was the question?
What made you choose to have a role in Vampire Diaries?
Sorry, I didn't get it.
What made you choose? And then I lost
the song.
Oh, I was getting used to accent. It's not you, trust me. It's me being like deaf in one ear because I flew with a little bit of cold and my ear got plugged and I think it's not unplugged yet. As well as me being Russian and I didn't sleep last night. So, and I'm having like, I have to concentrate to listen to accents just because it's so unusual to me. Okay, one more time.
What made you want to have a role on the Vampire Diaries?
Role in the Vampire Diaries. Okay, got it. Thank you. No, it's not you. I'm jet lagged.
I'm just dead.
Apparently, you and I, by the way.
Yeah.
That is actually a really interesting story and kind of, I would say, inspiring to me or maybe to you in some ways. So, being an actor is not as easy as it seems to be. It's not as glamorous as it seems to be. Being on set is the best thing in the world for someone who loves it, which I do love. And it's like, for me, the minute I book the job, I'm happy because that's what I love to do. I love to be on set and I love to create characters and I love playing in their world. But getting a job is really, really frustrating because, you know, for one role, like even for Nadia, they auditioned hundreds and hundreds of people from New York, Miami, Atlanta, Los Angeles. So they're seeing a lot of people and then it's only one person that they choose to play that role. So it's a huge competition. There's a lot of no's, you know, in the rooms. And it really doesn't have much to do with your acting a lot of times. It just, do you look apart? So, and a lot of times you don't look apart. You know, sometimes you're too short, sometimes you're too blonde, sometimes you're too brunette, sometimes you're too tall. Like, I mean, you name it. There's a lot of things that goes into it. So, by the time I kind of got to Vampire Diaries, the day before, I was so frustrated with all these auditions that I called my manager and I said, I don't know if this is what I want to do for the rest of my life of like kind of fighting for the jobs. You know, because I also have to overcome the fact that I do have an accent. So, and I've been working on that, but it's a different language. So there's a lot of obstacles, right? So I call my manager and she goes, I get it, you're frustrated. I get it, you're tired. You know what I mean? I understand that, but just relax. And I was like, no, tomorrow we're gonna talk about it and I think I'm gonna go do something else. I'm gonna go and, I don't know, work in a completely different part of, like not even in the business. I'm gonna go make creams or I'm gonna do perfumes, which I am making it now. Like I'm making my own skincare line. But before I was like, I didn't even, I was like, I'm gonna go do, I don't know, something else. And she calls me next morning and she goes, okay, you have a last minute audition. And you have to understand last minute audition means like you have 2 hours and you need to come in. In 2 hours, they give you 17 pages to study, right? So you have to study it, you have to break it down, you have to create a character. Like there's a lot of work that goes into it. And for me, I have to memorize it in order for it to sound authentic. So cut to, I'm like, oh, really? Come on, I'm not going to go. So finally my manager was like, just please go. And I said, fine, but I'm not going to be 100% prepared. She goes, okay. So I walked in and the room, literally was sitting in the room and there's about the same amount of girls sitting in that room. And I was like, ah, and they're all like blonde, redheaded, brunette, like they didn't have a particular type. And then there was two girls there that I still remember and they had huge movie came out and they were lead roles. And I'm like, of course they're going to give it to them. Why am I here? I just saw her on TV. She's doing really well. So cut to, I walk in, I do my scene, I leave. And then I come home. By the time I come home, that's about like 20 minutes. They call me and they say, can you be on the plane in 2 hours? You booked the show. I said, what? No. She goes, yes. I'm like, come on, you're kidding. She goes, no, you booked the show. So I was like, oh God, I have to get ready and da 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 da. So I tell my boyfriend at that time, who's now my husband, I told him, I was like, babe, I'm leaving just for 2 weeks. Like, I'll be back, but this is great news. Like, I know I wanted to quit yesterday, but today I don't. This is fantastic. I knew it's gonna happen. And then I left for 2 weeks, and 8 months later, I traveled back and forth, and I was already on the show. And so it kind of taught me something very interesting, that you can't quit if you love doing something. And when it feels to me, when you're really at that wall where you're like, oh, I'm done, I'm frustrated, I'm over this, that's when everything changes. It's the wildest thing. I've learned it over and over and over, that the minute you're there and you're about to quit, things are going to change. Dramatically, they're going to turn around the way you want to turn around. So, lesson from that, just don't give up. Continue doing what you're doing and know this. The minute you're stuck and you're about to give up, it will turn around.
I believe you've got a question.
He's like, no.
Oh, we did.
He's thinking like, he's like, oh, I remember there was a thing that I wanted to purchase over there on aisle of second and third. Which one was that?
Any questions from
Arkansas? Any questions?
Mm-hmm. We have a question from Sam.
Awesome.
What was it like working on Mill Steel?
Oh, amazing. That was another one. That was really cool because that was my first movie. And again, I was so nervous. I came in, I think like, as a matter of fact, we had a table read, so where they bring all the actors and you sit down at this round table, right? And so everybody's sitting there doing their lines. And so I come in and I'm like, oh my God, like Hugh Jackman is here. And like, really? And like this, and that, like, oh my God, like, oh, Spielberg is in the room. Like, I'm about to pass out. I have like a stone in my throat. I'm like, I'm gonna be like one of those girls that walks in the room and like passes out. So cut to, we're doing the whole like table read, meaning like you read your lines, you read your lines, like we go around it and we see how it sounds and all the characters. So it comes to me, before me, the little boy, right? I don't know if you saw that movie, but the little boy, like, literally, he's like playing with his toys, blah, 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 and then his teacher goes, you know, comes to his turn, his teacher points where to read, and he reads it perfectly. Like he's not even reading it. And I was like, oh man, like, now I'm done. And so it comes to me, and I'm like, I can't say the words, right? And then I guess because I was so nervous, my accent came out like you would not believe. I was like this in the action. And everybody just stopped and I was like, uh-oh. And they go, and they started laughing. And I was like, yes, I nailed it. And so the teacher came over later, a dialect coach, and he goes, we need to even pump it up. That's good, good. We need you have a very Russian accent. And I was like, well, I've been like just spending a year trying to get rid of it. Like, how do you want me to get it back? So, fun fact, you know, Isai Morales, who played in NYPD Blue, he's a Spanish actor, right, Latin actor. So I called him at that time and I was like, hey man, how do you do Russian accent? You played so well. And he goes, I'll teach you. Funny, right? So that's how I got my Russian accent in that movie. And then Spielberg didn't recognize me later because we did, that was really funny. So. By the way, stop me at any point because I just had tons of coffee and I can talk forever. So if anybody needs to go, please feel free. You know, like, I'm not going to be offended. So they did a screening and Mrs. Spielberg was there and they made us host. So there was an Armani and myself and somebody else was hosting it. I think the representative from DreamWorks. So, and I'm like, my hair is all, you know, pretty now and like curly and I'm wearing like this little cute little dress and I'm like, hi! So I'm like, oh my God. So we ended up talking, right? And he goes, so what did you do in the movie? And I was like, I'm the villain, Russian one. And he goes, oh, I didn't recognize you. You're so bubbly. And like, with your hair down. And I was like, yes. So that was really funny. That's my Spielberg funny story. And then he told me that it's always nice to play the opposite of who you are. And so in all my, literally all my roles, I never book a nice girl, like, or like funny girl. And I think like sometimes I can be funny. No, I never book it. I always book like psychos or like, you know, like my other show, Agent X, you should watch it if you've never seen it. Like she's a psycho, but she's like funny one, like a funny psycho. Oh, I think she's a funny psycho. I mean, at least I made her like kind of cool and psychotic. And then my other show, I play Badass Again. So, there you go.
I have some secrets in my closet.
I love Forensic Files. I love it. Mostly for the scientific part of it and psychological part of it. So I watch a lot of that for research. And I watch a lot of TV and movies for different research. So I watch everything. Like, I read everything. If you like point on anything on Netflix, most likely I watched it. It's really hard to choose movies with your husband because we'll sit down. Oh, that's really funny. We'll sit down and then he'll be like, okay, let's find a movie. And I'm like, okay. And we start. He starts browsing, right? And he goes, did you, oh, this looks good. And I'm like, so I saw it. He goes, okay, what about this? That's great. Yeah, I saw that. That was very nice. You'd enjoy it. What about this? And then like half an hour later, he's like, have you watched everything? Pretty much. But you choose one. I'll watch it with you again. Yeah, but then I'm like, you know, I also talk while I watch things. So then I'll be like, can you know? And then he goes this. Like, I mean, can you understand this? It's very annoying to him, I'm sure. I mean, he's commented a few times, but now that we've been together for so long, he doesn't comment anymore. He just goes sometimes, shh, I know you know. But yeah. Any more questions?
Time for one more, yeah.
Oh, time for one more. Who is the lucky winner? Ding, 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 ding,
no. You said you were going to be coming out with Charlie Sheen.
Yes.
How was it working with Charlie Sheen?
It was actually quite amazing. You know, it's interesting because I've seen his career, and he doesn't have the best reputation necessarily, right, as we all know. But when I met him, I was a little kind of like, you know, kind of, more not afraid necessarily, I wouldn't say afraid, but I was more of kind of like, you know, cautious of like how to approach a new cast member, right? So, but he ended up being the biggest gentleman I've met. Like, he was just so nice and so considerate, really funny. Like, he would leave little funny notes at different people's places. Like, say makeup artist would get like a face drawn on like one of her makeup things. And she'll come in and she'll be like, what's this? Oh, that's really funny, like funny stuff. He left a funny message on my car. And I come in, I'm like, what is this? And then I read it and I laughed, that was really funny. And then I was like, oh, that's from him. And he would make sure that we all get like in our makeup trailer. Usually we don't get like, you know, they can bring us food if we like breakfast and, you know, so and so on. He would be so kind and would bring us like all this like, you know, he gets all the like nice fruits and like, cool cheeses, you know, like nice plates, things that are more of even just for Charlie. And he would bring it and make sure that everybody eats it. And so it was really great experience. And he's, you know, he's an amazing actor when it comes to drama, because I didn't really see much of his dramatic work. It was mostly his comedy work. He's a fantastic drama actor. He's really good. And working with, you know, Luis Guzman was there, and Gina Gershon was there. I mean, Whoopi Goldberg, you know what I mean? It was like a really good cast, and I ended up literally working in elevator about this space, right? With five people for like good 4 weeks. It was very interesting, actually, working in a small area with nothing around besides walls, with all these amazing actors like in one space. I mean, I was terrified. I was like, oh my God, I have to really perform. So, and by the way, I got that movie while I was in Comic-Con in London, and I auditioned via computer, via Skype, with the director at 2 o'clock in the morning, London time. And then when I got to, I think we went to Cardiff, when I got to Cardiff, they flew me back, and right from the plane I went to set. So, looking forward for you guys to see it. I think it's going to be a great movie. I can't tell you much more than that. Well, thank you so much for your time. I really appreciate it.
A round of applause for all of them.
Okay. Thank you guys. Come support us on social media and so on. By the way, somebody should take a mic away from me, because I do have this obsession with mics, because I always wanted to be a rock star or a singer.
I'm just waiting for you to break in the song.
I'm taking it home with me.
There you go.
I feel very important right now. Thank you.